Welcome to the Great Outdoors RV Company. My name is Ryan Specht. And this is Mae Parker.
Yep. And we are checking out probably one of my favorite new floor plans, actually. Yeah. It's got everything. It's got the big bunks, which people really ask for, outside kitchen, which people really ask for, the price point, which, you know.
You can't beat it, really, especially for a fiberglass unit.
Yeah, and so it's got a lot of really cool things that I think you guys are going to like.
Too, we're less than 5,000 pounds gross weight. We're sitting at a dry weight of what,
3221. So that's really good, guys.
Yeah, you can pull it with just about any truck out there, and most SUVs these days can pull it.
Oh, and it has the Murphy bed too, which is another thing that really opens up the space, gives you like a couch and a bed. So
yeah,
let us show you a few things on the outside and then we'll move on to the inside.
Well, you mentioned that Murphy bed. A lot of times when you have the Murphy bed, you kind of sacrifice some of your pass-through storage. Not the way that Wildwood has got this thing set up. Look at this. Even with the Murphy bed, one of the largest pass-through storage areas in a coach this size that I've seen on the market. And then real simple, all your hookups and everything right here on the driver's side. You got your city water connection, where you fill your tank if you're going to be dry camping, exhaust for the furnace, hot water heater, 6 gallons, and of course your 30 amp power cord just spills right here, pulls out, plugs right into the pedestal.
Yep, nitrogen filled tires. It has two stabilizer jacks, one on each side for the rear, and then of course you have your tongue jack on the front to make your third point. Spare tire mounted on the back here. You also have a spot for a rear backup camera if you decide to add a backup camera. We carry those in our store.
This is neat too. You actually, each bunk has got its own little window that slides over, so these kids aren't in a little cave like a lot of times, you know?
Well, and half the time they don't even open up, so for this price point to have windows on both bunks and openable ones is pretty cool.
It is.
And this is a feature that you don't see on a lot of coaches either, but this is because of the outside kitchen.
Yeah, so, got a really nice spray port.
Yep, man, it's not hooked up, dang it. That could have like more views with that.
It's a little cold for that. Yeah. Let's wait till the summer.
Even better. This is cool because it has the outside kitchen. This is your drawer.
Got some storage area right here.
Yeah, that way you can put all your cold drinks out here. Now, this is a 110 refrigerator, so this will not work if you're just hooked up to just your battery power. You have to be hooked up to campsite power, but it really works as like a cooler as well if you needed to, not to get the inside dirty.
Yeah, and then you've also got, so you bring a grill along with you, plugs right into your propane tanks here, and right next to the fridge, you've got a 110 outlet as well as some 12-volt USB ports. And then right behind me, one of my favorite parts of this coach, look at the size of that window.
Yeah, this has got to be a 4 to 5 foot window.
Yeah, it's a big one.
Yeah, another 110 outlet right here, which is kind of cool. Large grab assist handle. Power awning with the lights underneath, so you just push a button for that to go in and out, and it's adjustable, so if you want to get all the water kind of heading one way or the other, you can do that. You also have a screen door, so if you want to get some airflow through here, yet still have some
bugs protection,
then you got it. You also have a solar port over here, so if you decide to hook up solar, you can do that. Now, this has the Furion solar charge connector, although you can really hook up anything to the different ports.
Yeah, it's just a matter of getting some adapters. Let's head on inside now, the 179DBK. This is a really neat feature. I'm sure you've seen some of the Murphy beds out there on the market, but this is the first one to be a sideways Murphy bed, and they do that to keep your coach nice and short, but still give you the ability to have a couch or a bed. So that couch will simply lay flat. I've already popped the pin on that side, and we simply pop the pin over here, and your Murphy bed comes right down. It's a nice size mattress, and as Mate was kind of pointing out there, you got a full-size wardrobe closet there at the foot of the bed. So even though you're a sideways Murphy bed, you still have a nice wardrobe area.
Yeah, and you might be wondering, what are these little cloth, whatever you call it, straps? Yeah, strappadoos. I think that's the technical term. This is for a wireless Bluetooth stereo that actually comes with the coach. So if you're going hiking, you want to sit by the fire, you can just pop it out. It really makes a lot of sense with everybody having smartphones nowadays to be able to do that and have multiple uses for it as opposed to just stagnant right on the side.
Yeah, and I mean, if there ever is a warranty issue, you're not tracing wires, you're not running down speakers, you just replace it.
I've actually listened to it. It sounds awesome.
Yeah, it actually puts out quite a bit of sound for something its size.
So pleated shades, this is that big window. And look at that.
That's the whole size of your dinette.
It's really amazing for this size coach to have that big of a window is awesome. So
not only do you have that big window right by the dinette, but that's also, if you needed it, you do have the big bunks in the Murphy bed, but this will make into another bed if you had that many people you were trying to sleep. You could pack a lot of guys into this little guy.
Yeah, absolutely. If you're worried about power, you have USB ports here, USB ports right by AUX right there, and then ones also right by the bed when it's folded down, or as a couch either way. And then USB ports in the kitchen as well. So you got a total of 8 USB ports to be able to charge your devices, which actually is kind of nice on a, you know.
Yeah, I mean, something this size, having that many 12-volt or DC ports, that's a really good setup. And as we just kind of looked at the kitchen, let's go over some of the really cool features that they've added to this season. They've gone away from the tiny little chintzy sink. You've got a big barn sink. You can actually wash your big pots and pans in there. Got nice storage up above. And if you had some taller items, the shelf can actually pop out of there, so you can put taller items in there if you wanted to. Good storage down below your sink as well. Quick access to your hot water heater right there, and then you've got a nice drawer here for like your utensils and stuff. And then below that, of course, you've got your furnace. Right behind me, you've got your refrigerator.
That's another thing that they didn't have last year. They didn't have nearly that size of fridge.
No, they didn't. It was the single door fridge with a little freezer inside of it. And this year they've gone to the bigger size gas electric refrigerator, of course. Below that, you've got your fuse panel, but look at the size of these bunks. This is awesome. I'm going to go ahead and crawl in here. It doesn't feel like a cave. Like we said, we got the windows. So I'm a 5'10 guy, and I'm in here pretty comfortable. And I think I could, you know, if I had a girlfriend or something along with me, we could easily both sleep in here.
Yeah. You also have a 13.5 air conditioner on top. That's more than enough. In fact, they use this same size AC for a unit. Gosh, even twice as big as this sometimes. So this will more than compensate for your area that you're trying to do. So you got furnace down low, which heat rises, cool up top, which cool lowers, right? And then this is actually a fairly decent size. Like, I could change in here if I needed to use this as like a changing room. You could totally do that. Vent on top. Of course, hot and cold water. Now, this does not have the plastic stuff on the side, so they recommend that you wipe this down after you're done showering in this type of wallboard type scenario. But yeah, you got your commode and your sink. That's another thing that they added just this year, which they didn't have before, was a sink for the bathroom. That it used to be just one sink in the kitchen area, and that was it. So that's kind of nice as well.
You know something else I noticed while I'm under here, mate? I didn't realize, but they started putting a light in here.
Oh.
On the bunk underneath.
That's cool.
So yeah, little guy down here can read a book or what have you.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm betting there's one up here as well. Oh yeah, of course.
Yeah.
That's a nice little touches, little things that they thought of. They really nailed it this year.
Yeah, so this is the 179DBK. So if you like this model, hit our like button. We always enjoy seeing your comments too. It's fun communicating to you guys and hearing what your ideas are of what you like, what you don't like. In fact, a lot of those ideas we toss. Wildwood, actually, FSX specifically, is probably one of the most responsive manufacturers out there. So if we tell them something, they're one of the few that actually get a lot of these ideas going. And so, especially on this product, let us know what you think.
Share your ideas with us, we'll share it with them, and then maybe together we can all come up with more advancements as the, you know, the years continue. Every year these guys get better and better and better, and it's because they're listening to our feedback and we're listening to your feedback.
Here we go.
Well, thanks for taking the time again with me and Mate here at the Great Outdoors RV Company, checking out the really cool FSX Platinum 179DBK.
If you need help with financing, usually we can get these things. We have about 20 different lenders that we're set up. So if you need help, if you have a few dings on your credit, if you want just a crazy good rate, even a longer term to get the payment under like $200 a month, you can do that with something like this. So give us a shout and we can help you do that. We even have an online
fill out a form type thing for your credit app, and we can give you some quick numbers too.
Yeah, and if you have any questions, don't hesitate to give us a call, 970-313-4337. Drop us an email, sales@thegreatoutdoorsrv.com or ryan@thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. Again, we'd love to hear your feedback.
Guys, have a great day.